Since the grand jury decisions in the Michael Brown and Eric Garner cases, Americans have had to face the issues of race and police brutality once again. Many have taken to protesting as a way to have their voices heard. On December 13, 2014, there were numerous protests nationwide, and I caught up with some of the protesters in Balboa Park to get their opinions on race relations with the police and what can be done to improve them.
This issue and racism in general is one of the most important, if not the most important, issue the country faces internally. Police departments need serious training in de-escalation techniques, and I think they need to stop looking at the color of a person's skin to decide what level of threat they're facing.
We're out here to really address the fact that we need to prevent this from happening. We need to stop being content with just reform measures of body cameras, of review boards. We're sick and tired of seeing people die and trying to justify it after the fact, all right? We're out here because we want to create true prevention, and we say that's only going to happen through accountability, through organizations pushing this message and making sure that it's heard loud in our communities. And we say instead of funding politicians who are going to put more funds into these police departments as if more training and more weaponry is going to stop the violence, we say invest in economic development. Give these youth something to do in the streets that is legal, that is possible for them to build up their community, because right now they see no other options.
And now as I'm looking and I'm seeing people of different races, I see white, I see people from Africa, I see some people who are Indian, I see all different types of people here. I see people who are of different races, of different skin color of mine, different hair color as mine, say, wearing shorts that say Black Lives Matter. And to me, that's gorgeous. That's beautiful.
Well, one of the big reasons of why I'm out here protesting is just because, like, I see the injustices firsthand, you know, within my community, of how, like, young men are arrested for really not really, like, vital reasons, you know, and it's just, like, I've been continuing to see how we as a Black and Brown nation, you know, have so much, like, barriers coming against us. I know, like, the people, we and the people in the police kind of need to work together if we do want to get changed. But at the same time, before we can even work together, these police officers have to demolish that racial stigma of us as a brown and Black people. You feel me? They have to get really internal with the issue and really ask, are they ready for this? You know, we need to have real officers out there with us. So it's like, and what we as a people need to step back and do as well. You know, so it's like, before people can even start working and bridging that gap with the police and with the people, we have a lot of internal healing to do. They have a lot of internal work to do. We, and I feel like in the upwake of Ferguson, the Eric Garner cases, a lot of people are having that internal conflict of, like, they're wearing our emotions right now, and that's blocking people from working with the police. But after we get through that, it's like there needs to be public town meetings with the police, with the people, and there needs to be a whole new system built.
No matter which side you're on, freedom of speech is paramount to the successful resolution of this obvious problem regarding police killing unarmed citizens. It doesn't matter what race the victims belong to. They are citizens of our country and deserve more judicious treatment. Those involved in law enforcement are civil servants, which means they are compelled to protect us. Yes, they have a very difficult and dangerous job, but the officers involved in the Brown and Garner cases are products of a system that is unquestionably flawed and not providing adequate training to law enforcement officials who were sworn to serve and protect us.